Yo guys, what's up? My name is Six and I'm finally back after like 9 months, and I've took a drastic break from gaming. I went to multiple vacations, I visited many countries with my friends, and I spent a lot of my time with my new girlfriend, and I genuinely had a really great time. However, I kinda started to miss gaming as a whole and creating content for you guys. And also, not to mention many unexpected oopsies regarding TF2 and CSGO happened since my magical disappearance. And just to name few which really caught my eye, the Great Depression bug. Although I'm pretty sure that all of you are aware of this oopsie, I'll try to explain it real fast. Basically, Valve broke something in the game's code while releasing an update, and there was an exploited people who unboxed some older crates. They would get an unusual hat with 100% unbox ratio, meaning they would get unusual from the every single crate they unboxed. Surely thousands of people abused the hell out of this bug by unboxing like 20 unusuals in a row, then selling them instantly on Steam Community Market for like, I don't know, $400 altogether, making a decent fortune for free. But Valve fixed this bug after like 24 hours, and they basically let people keep their first unusual unboxed tradable, and they made all the remaining unusuals they unboxed untradable and unmarketable. So unless you literally manually delete them from your own inventory, they're basically stuck in there forever. Anyway, regarding CSGO, there was a really huge change made also, and this happened just few days ago when Valve unexpectedly released an update in which they made all new keys purchased from the official in-game Valve store untradeable and unmarketable. And many people are still unaware what this update really means deep down. So, I'll try to explain it. In short, if you had a CSGO key which was bought before this update, you are all good. You can still sell this key on the Steam Community Market, you can still trade it as usual. However, if you are planning to buy a key from the in-game store right now, it will remain in your inventory forever unless you literally unbox it. Anyway, this time, unlike with the Great Depression bug, I've noticed this change straight away and quickly took action and sold all my low tier TF2 unusuals for TF2 Pure, and I switched it all to CSGO Pure, and I ended up with a total of 300 CSGO keys in my inventory. So let's make a quick math. Their original price before this update was about 2.3 euro a piece. Times it by 300 and it will run up to about 700-ish euro. Now, a few days after, and CSGO keys prices have nearly doubled and in some cases even tripled, which made me about 800 euro for free without any hassle of negotiating complex deals with greedy traders and all that stuff. So at the end, if I were to moralize about it and give you a lesson, it definitely does pay out to be aware of what's happening game-wise around you. You know, watch out for the upcoming updates, which could significantly affect the game and its economy, and you should always react very quickly, accordingly. I mean, this was just a matter of few hours and keys basically skyrocketed up, and same goes with the Great Depression thing. You know, if I was only at home during the Great Depression bug, I could have made more than 1000 keys, which is like 2000-ish and even more euros in a matter of few hours for doing absolutely nothing. So I could have gotten like $3,000, which is like 1500-ish keys, just by abusing these updates slash bugs, you know? So yeah, that's quite unfortunate, but you know, what can I do? This is basically it for today's video. And as I said, I'm planning to get back on track with my uploads and hopefully give this channel a second birth. So please let me know in the comments below this video what would you like to see in my next video. I'm planning to do some random TF2 game commentaries beside the whole trading mode of this channel. So I'll see how this will go. But until then, my name is 6media and see you all until the next one.